of bereavement. However, I want to impress upon you the importance that in a COVID environment. So I'm begging you, please keep all the COVID protocol. Wear your mask, social distance, and if the need arises, please sanitize. Again, I thank you for the support that you've given us. It has meant a whole lot to us. I want to say a special thank you to my siblings and their spouses who have journeyed all from America to be with us in this environment and in this trying time. I now ask Mr. Dean, please excuse me for not giving you your full title. He will do a short eulogy before the official service begins.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wood. Somebody told me that I don't really need a microphone this morning, but nevertheless, it has been presented to me, and I will make best use of it. Can I have the attention of all, please? Just for a few moments as I present this eulogy on behalf of the Wood family. I recognize all dignitaries this morning, inclusive of Lieutenant Commander David Braffitt, the commanding officer of the Barbados Coast Guard, Reverend Willoughby, one of the chaplains of the Barbados Defense Force, as well as Captain Clark, the Force Welfare Officer, and of course, Mistress Eleanor Gittins, GAP. Eleanor Gill, GAP, Staff Officer Civilian of the Barbados Defense Force. I also recognize the presence of all family, friends, and acquaintances. It is with a deep sense of humility and sadness that I stand here to deliver this eulogy on the behalf of the Wood family and to bid a fond farewell to our beloved sister, mother, grandmother, aunt, and friend. To thank Almighty God for her life, for her witness, and for her work, and to thank Him for lending her to us to be our companion on this earthly pilgrimage. We're also gathered here to mourn with her family at her passing. Sonia was the sixth of nine children born to the late Alan and Beryl Wood of 2nd Avenue, Bel Air, St. George, and was educated at St. Augustine's Girls and St. George Secondary School. It was at the St. Augustine's Church that she was nurtured spiritually along with her siblings, and was well grounded in the words of Scripture. She loved her family well, and while she loved her children dearly, her biggest sacrifices and greatest love was reserved for her grandchildren. If you knew Sonia, you knew she had a big grandson plus two other grandchildren. Sonia was a cook par excellence. She worked at several reputable hotels around Barbados, but got her greatest joy working at the Barbados Defense Force, where she would be stationed at either headquarters, Paragon, or Pelican Base. Her sister said that as far as she was concerned, food was only eatable if it was cooked the way Sonia cooked it. And if you overcook vegetables, she would waste no time in saying to you that it has mashed up the vegetables. And she would threaten to call the police to lock you up. The soldiers also knew when Sonia cooked, and she would always buy those added ingredients to add to the food to give it that extra taste and flavor. As she would often say, the soldiers work hard and should eat well. I got to know Sonia much better while taking her to work on mornings and evenings while she was stationed at Paragon Base. The alternative was for Sonia to take the 5:30 bus on mornings from St. George, head to Bridgetown, and then take a 6 o'clock bus to Fairy Valley if she was lucky to get one. And so by taking her most mornings by 7 a.m., she'd be at her place of work, a place that she loved dearly. Her sister also remembers her as the one who was never confrontational. However, if your opinion did not coincide with hers, she will let you know frankly that you was talking foolishness and suggested that you get a good bush bath. She loved to dress and was in a class of her own. In speaking to a friend of mine about her death, she did not know exactly who he was talking about, but her reply was, "You mean a short lady that always have her hair well done and always dressed neat and tidy and well-spoken?" I said, "Yes, that is the one." Her colleagues at Paragon, Archer, Debbie, Donna, Junior, Davis, Goodridge, Corporal Lowe, all spoke highly of her, especially her love for music and dancing, and described her as a loving, kind, and a joy to be with. And her death was a big blow to all of them. I want to take this opportunity on behalf of the Chief of Staff, all officers, warrant officers, civilian staff, enlisted ranks, both serving and retired, her friends, and on my own personal behalf, and on the behalf of Ingrid, Hazel Waithe, and Eugene Grimes, to take this opportunity to extend our deepest sympathy to her family. Cry if you want to, for the one that you loved has crossed over the shores. Remember the good times that you shared, the love, the laughter, the meal, the gathering. Death also allows us the opportunity to reflect on our own lives. And as we lay the mortal remains of our sister to its final resting place, we pause and ask the question, what lessons can we learn from her life to help us on our earthly pilgrimage? And I say, love one another, be willing to give, forgive, enjoy life, and always give thanks and praise. Sonia, your life and work is over. We thank you for your contribution to the development of the Barbados Defense Force and to your family, and for all that we have accomplished and all that you have accomplished. All that is left for me to do now is to say in those ancient words so often often repeated at funerals, the Latin liturgy of the Western Church. Sonia, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs receive you at your arrival and lead you to the holy city, Jerusalem. May choirs of angels receive you, and with Lazarus, who was once poor, may you have eternal rest. Goodbye, my friend. Goodbye until we meet again. Thank you very much.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed. Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. With faith in Jesus Christ, we now receive the body of our sister Sonia Marcel for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed by the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Sonia. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The opening hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine.
Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his Spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song.
This is my story. This is my song. Praise my Savior.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who by the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, destroyed death and brought life and immortality to light, grant that your daughter, Sonia Marcel, being raised with him, may know the strength of his presence and rejoice in his eternal glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God forever and ever. Amen. I ask you all now to turn with me to page 4 of your booklets, as we have a recitation of Psalm 23, and we will say alternate verses. Psalm 23, found on page 4 of our leaflets. The Lord is my shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing.
He shall feed me in a green pasture, and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort.
He shall convert my soul, and bring me forth in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I may fear no evil. For you are with me, thy rod and thy staff comfort me.
Thou shalt prepare a table before me against them that trouble me. Thou hast anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Though there is no formal sermon, I wish to commend the words of Psalm 23 to all those who at this day are pained in their heart. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. While the pains may be fresh, we may never forget the Almighty God is always near to us in our times of sorrow, in our times of pain, in our very weakness. He stands to bolster and hold us up. We know. Lead and bow our heads in prayer, not only for the souls of our sister, but for us who are gathered here today, who mourn her loss. And after each petition, the response shall be, "Hear us, Lord." For our sister, Sonia, let us pray to the Lord Christ, who said, "I am a resurrection and I am life." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us now who mourn for Sonia, and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the graves of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raise the dead to life. Raise our sister Sonia to eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister Sonia to the joys of heaven. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister Sonia. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our sister Sonia, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that her death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way, and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, to the ages of ages. Amen. Father of all, we pray to you for Sonia and for all those whom we love but no longer see. Grant to them eternal rest. Let a light perpetual shine upon them. And may she, and all the faithful departed, through the tender mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of humankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, your servant with your saint, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Let us commend our sister Sonia to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Sonia, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil. Set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Leave us not, and deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Sonia Marcel. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. We now ask our brother Karim Agard to come forward and render a solo in tribute of our sister.
Good morning to everyone.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye, gone too soon. Shiny and sparkly and splendidly bright, here one day, gone one night. Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon, gone too soon. Like a castle built upon a sandy beach, gone too soon. Like a flower that is just beyond your reach, gone too soon. Born to amuse, to inspire, to delight, here one day, gone one night. Like a sunset dying at the rising of the moon, gone too soon, gone too soon.
I now ask the pallbearers to come forth as we bear our sister to her final resting place. Trampling down death by death and giving life to those in the tomb. The Son of Righteousness is gloriously risen, giving light to those who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. The Lord will guide our feet into the way of peace, having taken away the sin of the world. Christ will open the kingdom of heaven to all who believe in his name, saying, "Come, O blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you." Sonia Marcel, into paradise, may the angels lead you. At your coming, may the martyrs receive you and bring you into the holy city, Jerusalem. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one, have mercy upon us. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, "Write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, O Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins. And at our last hour, let us not fall away from you. For in sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister, Sonia Marcel, and we now commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our sister Sonia and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved, the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal grant unto her, O Lord. May she and all the faithful departed in the mercy of God rest in peace. And may the Lord bless her and keep her. May the Lord make his face to shine upon her and be gracious unto her. May he lift up and let his countenance upon her and grant her eternal peace. Amen. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where's my help to come? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who watches over you will not fall asleep. Behold, he who keeps watch over Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand, so that the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. The Lord shall watch over your going out and your coming in, from this time forth and forevermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The hymn, "Oh, I want to see him, to look upon his face."
Oh.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. The hymn, Amazing Grace. Of day. The nations made much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken. God has spoken, and the earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come now and behold the works of the Lord. What awesome things he has done on earth. It is he who makes wars to cease in all the world. He breaks the bow, shatters the spear, and burns the shields with fire. Oh, thanks. Be still then and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be.
World without end. Amen.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul.
Attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul.
In you. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, my good above all other. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble among the people. But those who run after other gods shall have their troubles multiplied. Their libations of blood I will not offer, nor take the names of their gods upon my lips. O Lord, you are my portion and my cup. It is you who upholds my lot. My boundaries enclose a pleasant land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who gives me counsel. My heart teaches me night after night. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not fall. My heart therefore is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. For you will not abandon me to the grave, nor let your Holy One see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy. And in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. The day thou givest, Lord, is ended. The darkness falls at thy behest. To thee our morning hymns ascended. Thy praise shall sanctify our rest. The hymn, "The Day Thou Givest, Lord," is ended.
Thank you.
Lord be with you. Let us pray. Merciful Father and Lord of all life, we praise you that humanity is made in your image and reflect your truth and light. We thank you for the life of your daughter, Sonia Marcel, for the love and mercy she received from you and showed among us. Above all, we rejoice at the gracious promise to all your servants, living and departed, that we shall rise again at the coming of Christ. And we ask that in due time, we may share with our sister Sonia that clearer vision when we shall see your face in the same Christ our Lord. Amen. And now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Amen. And my brothers and sisters in Christ, unto God's gracious mercy and protection I now commit you. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and remain with you. Be a source of comfort and consolation in these days and forevermore. Amen.
Come stop your crying, it will be all right. Just take my hand, hold it tight.
What do they know? We need each other. look over your shoulder. Just look over.